Sweet Sir Galahad came in through the window in the night when the moon was in the yard. He took her hand in his and shook the long hair from his neck, and he told her she'd been working much too hard. It was true that ever since the day her crazy man had passed away to the land of poets' pride, she laughed and talked a lot with new people on the block, but always at evening time she cried. And here's to the dawn of their days. La la dee 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 dee, la 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 la. She moved her head a little down on the bed until it rested softly on his knee. There she dropped her smile, and there she sighed a while, told him all the sadness of those years that number three. Well, you know I think my fate's belated, 'cause of all the hours I waited for the day when I'd no longer cry. I get myself to work by 8, but oh, was I born too late? Do you think I'll fail at every single thing I try? Lines of a smile erased, the tear tracks upon her face, the smile that could linger, even stay.